Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It has been a while since I have filmed a beauty related video because while I haven't really been that interested in filming anything beauty related, but today I wanted to try out this magnetic eyeliner eyelash suit that I got off of eBay. I'm gonna link it in the description bar down below in case you are interested and you are based in Australia, because I know they deliver in Australia. I don't know if they deliver outside of Australia, but I'm pretty sure you can find something similar in your area if, let's say, you're in the United States or you are in, let's say, the UK. Anyway, so I did try and curl my hair a little bit for a little bit of a change in my look. But yeah, so this one I got from eBay. I ordered it on the 25th of July. It was meant to arrive on the 30th, but it only arrived on the 3rd of August. Okay, so technically, I didn't, I didn't fail on my no spend just yet, okay? So anyways, let's see how it goes. I'm gonna show you the application method. Well, I'm gonna show you the unboxing first and the application process. And I'll do a review at the end of the day, just to give you like sort of a first impressions on how it feels, having it on, whether it's difficult, if it ever had fallen off or anything like that, okay? So yeah, let's go and see. Okay, so I received this yesterday, but let me just... It's called the Magnetic Eyeliner Eyelash Suit. That's what it says on there. And on the back it says, Magnetic Eyeliner Eyelash Suit includes magnetic eyelashes, magnetic eyeliner fluid, eyelashes with special tools. Usage method, shake the magnetic eyeliner 10 to 20 times. Apply the magnetic eyeliner to the eyelids and wait a minute for it to dry out. Absorb the magnetic eyelashes onto the eyeliner with a tool or hand to complete the wear. And it also has a section that says taboo. I don't know what that is. Magnetic eyelashes can only be worn after the magnetic eyeliner has dried out. So I need to wait for this to dry completely, unlike with the normal lash glue where you kind of have to wait till it's still a little bit wet and tacky before you apply it. So let's see what's inside. Okay. So it comes with three sets of lashes, the magnetic glue, and sort of tweezer. I already own one of these. I have a purple one right here. But having a backup isn't bad, so that's fine. I'll just keep it there. And this one, I've got obviously my eye makeup on. I've got my black eyeliner on. Now this one, it looks like a liquid eyeliner. I think we're gonna be okay. I have used liquid eyeliner in the past. So, and then the design of the lashes that I chose is sort of like it's not the most ridiculous, but it's also not the most natural looking. So you would still be able to tell that I am wearing false lashes when I've got this deep. I'm just gonna go ahead and take my mirror closer to the camera so that you can see what I'm doing. And as they said, to apply this, let it dry, and then once it's dry, go ahead and apply the lashes. So we need to wait until it's completely dry. I'm gonna go ahead and just line my lashes with this, or my lash line with this. It looks black. I don't know if it will dry black. So I'm gonna let that dry a little bit and apply on the other side as well. Okay. I'm not taking it too inside the, like not too in the inner corner, because I'm not applying the lashes all the way there. So just where I feel like the lash would go on. And it looks like it's gonna take a little bit of time for it to dry completely. But so we're gonna go ahead and wait for that. Now while we are waiting, I wanted to show you what the lashes look like up close. So I don't know if you can see that in between where they attach to whatever this is called. It seems like that's where the magnets are, and if you look closely, you can tell that there are sort of like five positions where they attach. So I'm not sure if this is something that you can cut off if the lashes are too long, like you know how you trim lashes usually when they come on too long. But oh, okay. And okay, I'm gonna try and pull it. It's fairly easy because it's not glued, it's magnet. So there's sort of like a metal line there that the magnet attaches to. Where'd it go? Okay, it fell. Okay, I think it's dry. So I'm gonna try this one on. And it's attaching itself to the tool. So just be careful and hold it sort of like farther from the rest of it. Let's see. Oh, I really can feel it touching. Wow. That is probably the easiest false lash application I have ever had to do. And so far my eyes are not watering. It's not reacting to the magnetic liner. Yeah, that was pretty easy. You can obviously, and what's good about this is that because it's magnetic, you can obviously like reposition it without having to add any more of the liner or the glue. So let's do the other one. And I love the design of this one that I chose. This one I'm going to apply with my fingers just to see if it is as easy. They like really just attach to each other. No dramas. Wow. Okay. So I'm gonna be wearing this for the rest of the day, and then I will let you guys know if it has fallen off, if I have any issues with it, if I develop any kind of irritation around my eyes, because that's usually a very sensitive area. So far looking good. It doesn't feel heavy. It doesn't feel like it's gonna go anywhere, and I really like what it's done to my eye. Okay, all right. I will see you all again. It is 11 o'clock in the morning, so it gets dark pretty early, so maybe around 4 p.m. I'll see you again. That'll be like 5 hours into filming, just to give you an idea of how it's been going. Okay guys, it's been a couple of hours now. I'm going to take this off. One of the things that annoy me when I put on false eyelashes is the removal part. A lot of the times it would tug on my actual lashes, hurt like hell, pull out my lashes, and also difficult to remove when you wash it off. So I thought that I would show you guys how that process would be like. Okay, so let's take this off. We'll start with... Oh, that was easy and painless. And also, it doesn't... I don't know if you can see that. But it doesn't look grimy at all. Because, look, there's no glue. Wow. Okay. And, so you see that that black line there, which is actually metal. I'm just going to go ahead and connect that back on. That is so freaking easy. No pain. So easy. No grime. Reusable multiple times. As long as you still have the magnetic eyeliner, I think you can use this many, many times. And I'm glad that I picked the one that has the, like, the three pairs of lashes, the three sets. Because I have a feeling we're going to be filming a lot of videos with these lashes on. Okay, now I'm going to go ahead and use my eye makeup remover, and I'll show you guys how, whether it's going to be easy or not to take it off. Okay, coming in closer that you can see, I only ever use my oil-free eye makeup remover from Neutrogena. So that's what we're using today. And then typically I would remove, let's just put a headband on. I would remove it with the makeup remover, and then I would wash the rest of my face, obviously to remove the rest of the makeup. So, cotton pad. And then, let me just have a look at what's left there. I don't think that is the magnetic liner. I think that's my Inglot eyeliner. That won't come off easily. Okay. So in terms of removing it, it's not that bad. It's basically just the same way or the same difficulty as, well, actually no, it's, this one's easier because there's no glue residue that gets stuck on my lash line that I have to, like, really go ahead and, like, see, there's nothing left on this eye. It's gonna go ahead and soak this a little bit. Actually, that black thing that remains, maybe, because my Inglot liner isn't really that difficult to remove, but so this might be the liner. But see, it's gone, it's clean. Oh, my eyes look different without makeup on. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and wash the rest of my face. Okay, so here's our clean face and nothing left around the eyes. That is so easy. And there you have it. So I think this was a good choice. I definitely do recommend it, but you would have to try it yourselves. And I would actually recommend to do a patch test off the magnetic glue or magnetic eyeliner first. Don't copy me and put it directly on your eyes, because you never know if you have a reaction to it. So do a patch test, and if you don't have a reaction, then go ahead and use it. But yeah, don't copy me on that part. But overall, I really enjoyed these magnetic eyelashes. It didn't fall off in the whole time that I was wearing it. there's no irritation for me so far. And yeah, it was a pretty good and cool process.